Our next speaker is Luna Nguyen. She's a Vietnamese Marxist-Leninist popular educator and vlogger. Her videos on her Luna Oi YouTube channel explain the nature of Vietnamese socialism and explore Vietnam's history. Her work has received hundreds of thousands of views, confirming her status as one of the most effective communicators of Vietnamese Marxism in the English language. She's currently working on an English translation of the official Vietnamese curriculum on Marxist theory, which should be absolutely fascinating. Luna, what a fantastic idea. Take it away.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me. I'm Luna. I'm a Vietnamese communist born and living in Vietnam. I have a YouTube channel named Luna Oi where I talk about a variety of topics about Vietnam. And it is my honor to have a chance to speak in our very important event today. As a Vietnamese born and living in Vietnam, my whole life I've been like hearing Western media spreading distortions and misinformation about Vietnam, about how authoritarian we are and how we don't have a democracy. The lies about Vietnam are often absurd and even laughable, but unfortunately they influence millions of people around the world, especially people living in the bourgeois democracy. The people who pushing these lies are pretty good at what they do, actually. They know their audiences and they know what most people in the imperial core are predisposed to believe in the imperialist lies. And they know how to spark outrage and sow distrust in socialism among the working people of the developed West. I've made many videos on my channel in which I've talked about Vietnam's socialism, our elections, our land reforms, and our labor unions. In producing these videos, I have learned a lot about my country. And in interacting with comrades from all around the world, I've come to see just how different Vietnam's political system is from the most of the rest of the world. And the more I learn, the more I realize how lucky I am to have been born in Vietnam. So that I am here to say that, despite the imperialist lies you've no doubt heard, Vietnam does have a strong system of socialist democracy. One of the most common attacks leveled against Vietnamese democracy is that we only have one leading political party, the Communist Party of Vietnam. So therefore, we are a dictatorship and authoritarian. The fact is that, like, as I made very clear in my "How Do Elections Work" in my video, you do not need to be a party member to run for office in Vietnam. In fact, we have many national representatives who are not party member. Vietnam actually has 5 times more independent members of our National Assembly than the House and the Senate of the USA. That said, it is true that the overwhelming majority of our National Assembly are members of the Communist Party of Vietnam. And why might that be? Well, this might be a shock for some of you, but a lot of communists win elections in Vietnam because a lot of Vietnamese people are communists. In the Asia Barometer Survey, an independent poll conducted in 2 separate years in the University of Taiwan, 85% of Vietnamese people approved the government in Vietnam. That's the highest consistent approval rating on any country in Asia. We also have a much different idea about what democracy means in Vietnam than most other Asian countries, with the majority of Vietnamese defining democracy as social equity. So yeah, we vote communists because we are communists. And why should that come as a surprise? For a century now, generations of Vietnamese people have made a huge sacrifice to build socialism in Vietnam. We had a successful revolution. We fought and won many wars with the most powerful countries on earth to have our own self-determination. A lot of foreign propagandists want to make you think that our revolution was similarly rooted in nationalism and not communism. They want you to think that soldiers like my grandpa, who died in Tet Offensive in the Vietnam War, were not really communists and they didn't really care about communism. And they want you to think that we don't really care about building socialism today. I am here to tell you that that's all wrong. We know exactly what we're doing and where we want to go. We are not a nation of victims and oppressed people who are yearning for capitalism. Nah. We are, by and large, committed socialists, and we believe in the Communist Party because it has materially improved our lives for decades now. And one more thing, seriously, if we are really oppressed, we're going to be the first ones to free ourselves. We beat the Japanese fascists. We beat the French colonialists. We beat the USA imperialists. If you really think that we really feel oppressed by our own government, we couldn't overthrow it. Just look at our history and you will have your answer. Now let's compare our socialist democracy to capitalist bourgeois democracy that Western media outlets have been pushing on us for decades, such as the quote-unquote democracy in the USA. Theoretically, the United States has two-party system with the Democrats and the Republicans, and this is somehow supposed to be superior to our system. Now let me quote Julius Nyerere, the first president of Tanzania. The US is a one-party state, but because of its typical American extravagance, they have two of them. So the Democratic Party and the Republican Party are just two different faces of one capitalist party. Every 4 years, they just take turns making a show of pretending to shift power around while the ruling class pulls the strings behind the scenes. No matter which party is in charge, the US still bombs other nations, still refuse to give millions of American workers a living wage, still refuse to give its people universal health care, and still put children in cages. No matter what party takes power in any given election, there's still ever increasing police brutality, more and more homeless people. And to cover their ugly nature, the US has been sugarcoating a situation with beautiful buzzwords such as freedom and democracy. But have you ever asked, what kind of freedom do you have? Freedom to die because of a preventable disease? Freedom to lose your jobs without any protection from a global pandemic? And freedom to be evicted because you couldn't afford your crappy, overpriced apartments owned by rich landlords? The only choice you have is an illusionary choice to vote red or blue. And both the DNC and the GOP exist to maintain the dominance of the bourgeois class. Countless studies have shown that bourgeois democracies such as the US, UK, and Canada, and France heavily prioritize the will of wealthy while dismissing the concerns of the working class. For all the derision of Vietnam for not having like independent voices in our National Assembly, how many times has a third party candidate actually won in Congress in the USA? And how much of a voice do independent Congress representatives have even when they do win some seats? None whatsoever. Democracy under capitalism is an illusion. You have an illusion of choice, but in reality, you have no power whatsoever. Just in Vietnam, we have one leading party, but our Communist Party is a party of the people, built by the people and supported by the people. We fought tooth and nail to have our own Communist Party. To us, for now, it is the safest way to protect ourselves in this capitalist hellhole, where the imperial court constantly wants us to die off for imperialist profits. Lots of leftists criticize us of being like authoritarian without acknowledging the reason why we had to have a communist revolution to begin with. Colonialism and imperialism imposed upon us by your countries, and heavy interventionism and constant attacks to this day from your hostile and aggressive bourgeois government. The fact is, in Vietnam, we do have a dictatorship of the proletariat, meaning our government is controlled by the majority of our people. We have a strong labor unions, rapidly improving infrastructures, and 90% of Vietnamese people own our own homes and have a full healthcare coverage. And just look at the no person left behind policy of Vietnam in the face of COVID-19 versus the genocide and neglect which nations like the USA, the UK have inflicted upon your own citizens. Look at how we sacrifice our economy again and again to save all people. And then compare to the USA, you will see the stark difference between socialist democracy and capitalist democracy. If you're a leftist in the West, especially from the imperial core, I hope you can look at what countries like Vietnam have been doing, learn some lessons from our victories, and then focus on building your own socialist movement in your countries. And also, please be aware of the lies and misinformation about countries like Vietnam and learn to investigate before you speak. There's a reason why the capitalists want you to hate and distrust Vietnam. It's because they don't want you to have what we have. Thank you so much for listening and hope we all stay strong. Solidarity.
That was fantastic, Luna. If Western democracy could be defended with such conviction as you have defended socialist democracy, it would have no problem. But since that is not so, it's in deep trouble. Because it cannot be defended, and you, people like you, have defended socialist democracy so magnificently. Thank you very much.